And plus, I drenched this in a couple layers of super glue. And what I'm going to do is take my hole puncher, and what I'm going to do is just punch a hole out right here. What's up, guys? So today we are making the web shooter from the Amazing Spider-Man 2 movie. So if you guys are new to this channel, please make sure you hit that like button and smash that subscribe button and turn on all those bell notifications. So a matter of fact, let's just jump into the whole tutorial right now. So guys, to get started, I made this template for you guys so you guys can print it out for yourself. So guys, when I looked this up on Google, this is a Sean's Crafts template when I found it on Google. So I'm going to show you how I found this on Google. So basically, I searched up the Amazing Spider-Man 2 web shooter template, and here is the results and images of what you will get. And once you scroll down and find the correct image, you will see this image right here. So that was the quick little summary of how I found that on Google. So the first piece I'm going to take up the assembly is piece number one. So I basically cut it out. Plus I'm carving out this little black square piece right here. So basically, I transferred that piece onto a piece of foam. So now, I'm going to cut that piece out of the foam. So guys, here is the whole piece cutting out. So guys, this part right here is like a little bit harder to cut out because you have to use like a lot of force to cut this piece out. But this is how far you will get on this piece. So next up, I took piece number two and cut them out twice onto foam. So guys, now I took some hot glue and I'm gonna glue them, the two pieces on right here. So guys, here are both of the pieces glued on. So guys, now I just took piece number three and I transferred it onto some thinner pieces of craft foam. So basically the two pieces will be glued right here. So for piece number four, I traced it twice again onto more thinner sheets of foam. So basically, I glued the piece right here. So guys, now I'm gonna start making a little popsicle stick piece, which is what's gonna block the bullet from releasing before it shoots. And plus, I drenched this in a couple layers of super glue. So guys, now I'm gonna start adding some tape onto the popsicle stick. So guys, now we're taking piece number seven, and we're basically gonna roll the piece up into a tube. And before we glue it shut, you need to do a test fit so that your spring can slide through clearly. So once that's done, you can now glue the barrel shut. So guys, now there are two strips of paper that are supposed to go on the tip of the web shooter. So what I'm doing is just rolling those two strips of paper onto the tip of the barrel. So guys, basically there's a strip that goes right here and another strip that goes right down here. So guys, now I cut up a piece of cardboard. And what I'm going to do is take my hole puncher, and what I'm going to do is just punch a hole out right here. So with that hole punch, I basically cutting out this little ring. So basically, that ring gets glued on right to the edge of the barrel, which is supposed to go right here. So, and then I'm gonna drench that ring in a couple layers of hot glue. So once the hot glue on this piece dries, you can insert it right here. But before I insert it, I'm gonna paint everything in this gloss red coat. So guys, now that these two pieces had a chance to dry, I'm gonna start gluing the two pieces together. So now that these two pieces are glued together, I'm gonna set them aside for now. So guys, now I'm gonna start making the bullet of the web shooter, which is the thing that's gonna shoot out of the web shooter whenever I flex my wrist. So guys, now that I wrapped the paper around the wooden dowel, I'm gonna now glue the spring onto the barrel. So now I'm gonna set the bullet aside for now. And plus guys, the front of the web shooter has some black pieces. So basically I cut out the two black pieces out of some black craft foam. So guys, the two black pieces will be put in right here. So guys, now there are two more black pieces, and those two black pieces gets put on right here. Okay, so guys, now we are going to make the centerpiece that's raised up. So for that, you'll need four pieces of some craft foam. And what you're going to do is stick the two pieces of foam together like this. So now this is what the piece should look like. So now I have another piece of craft foam that's like this shape, and this piece gets placed right here. So once this piece gets painted red, you can now glue it onto the web shooter. So guys, now I have these two red pieces right here. So guys, now I'm just gonna put these onto the web shooter right here. So So guys, now I have these like black circle pieces right here. So these pieces get glued right here. So guys, now I'm going to start making the button piece. So for the button piece, I'm going to use a piece of craft foam. And to get the looks of it, I'm going to start by using a cap of a Sharpie. So I'm going to press that all the way in until you have a circle that looks like this. And then I'm just going to use a tip of a pen. So now this is what you should get. So now that you have this piece painted red, you can put this piece on to the web shooter right here. And another piece that goes right here, but no power button. So guys, now I'm making the two silver pieces. So to make them, I'm going to use a silver Sharpie. So guys, what I'm doing now is just using a black fine point marker. So these are what the two pieces should look like once you cut them out. So the two pieces gets glued on right here. So guys, now I'm going to glue this piece onto the web shooter right here. So guys, now I made the web cartridge of the web shooter. So the web cartridge gets put in back here on this part of the web shooter. So guys, now I just glued the web shooter right back here. So now I just put some fishing line onto that popsicle stick piece that's right here. So guys, now we are all done making the web shooter. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, please make sure you hit that like button and smash that subscribe button and turn on all those bell notifications. And please comment down below my next video. So see you in the next one.